Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Gene, its nature, expression and regulation. In that we are studying topic component for protein synthesis. Now to make that protein, there are various components required, right from your DNA till your ribosomes. Today we'll be studying what are the different requirements to make that protein or polypeptide molecule. So just to synthesize that one polypeptide or protein molecule that has got a peptide linkage to it, there are a number of things that are required. First is your deoxyribonucleic acid that will contain that genetic information or that genetic code. Secondly, your messenger RNA, or you simply say it mRNA. Third, your transfer RNA, or you say it tRNA. Next, your ribosomal RNA or rRNA. And finally, amino acid sequences, that is AUGC in case of protein formation, not the other way around. Also, it has to be taken place when all of these molecules coordinate together or work in a proper fashion to make that one protein molecule. Now, the components for protein synthesis would include, first, deoxyribonucleic acid, or the sequence of bases, that is the genetic information containing molecule DNA. Messenger RNA is nothing but sequence of bases that are complementary to DNA. Now, your messenger RNA will copy one strand or the coded information strand from DNA to RNA or mRNA. tRNA or transfer RNA has sequence of bases which are complementary to the codon region which is present on mRNA. Your rRNA is nothing but a site of protein synthesis, or wherever your mRNA comes, your rRNA or ribosomal RNA comes and attaches to it, and your tRNA brings amino acids and attached to the mRNA, anticodon codon loop is formed which helps the polypeptide to form a chain. And finally, amino acids are very essential since they are transported to the ribosome by the tRNA, and this amino acids would be joined together by forming peptide linkage to form that whole polypeptide or protein molecule. So students, in this part of the chapter, we just laid down the requirements that we require to form a protein molecule. I hope you all are very clear about this concept. Thank you.